Good evening, good morning, good afternoon, Philippines, and everywhere beyond. A cold Monday evening, this is DJ Sebastian from LHS.
And this is DJ Torres from LHS.
You're now listening to Late Night Talks of 99.9 Evander Radio.
Where you can relax and listen to. First up is an original drama written by the station's own best.
Here is For a Day More.
One rainy night, a girl was driving on her own. When suddenly, her car crashed.
Number 800,401 to the 10th power. Odette Sullivan.
Huh?
Died on the 18th of December, year 2020, in a single vehicle crash.
I'll have you know I feel very much alive, alive enough to sue you. How dare you say such fallacies about me?
Case to decide whether the defendant goes to the good place or the bad place is now in session.
We interrupt this program for a quick reminder.
It is now 12:05 in the evening.
This time check is brought to you by the Department of Health.
Isang taon pa lang ako, nasundana ni Toto. Grade 2, 8 taon pa lang, apat na bata ang inaalagaan. Grade 6, 12 na ako, kasing dami na ng pamilya ko. Sabi mo, pasensya na, walang pera kaya mag-drop out ka. Inakop, sabi mo kami mahal nyo. Aray ko, ba't di kayo nagplano? Sana hindi gutom at nag-aaral pa. Alag at malusog ang buong pamilya.
Ang planadong buhay, makaayos na buhay.
You're still listening to For a Day More at 99.9 Evander Radio.
Where in the world am I? And who the hell are you?
My identity is of no concern to your case. I'm only the judge, the guardian of the celestial crossroads, and you are here to see if you are worthy of the good place or the bad place.
As ridiculous as everything seemed to Odette was, she had to accept that what was happening right now was real. She vaguely remembers a car crash like a distant dream that turned out to be her reality. She's dead now, and she must deal with that.
Fine. Say I did die on that crash. What of it? Is it really necessary to hold a whole trial for something that's so painfully obvious? I deserve to go to the good place.
Admirable confidence, but we only accept facts in this court and not baseless assumptions. Witnesses will be brought in to see if what you claim is true. Miss Odette Sullivan, bring in the first witness.
You know what? It's so hard to find a job right now. Can you recommend me some? Oh, this is a new place. Oh, Miss Sullivan is here. Good morning, ma'am. Good afternoon? Maybe evening? I don't have a watch on me right now. Terribly sorry.
You? I remember you. I fired you. Why are you here? Judge, what is she doing here? Is she dead too?
Luna Estelle Vermont, former personal assistant of Odette Sullivan, employed for 5 years and dismissed from her position on the 31st of October. Testifying. Current status, alive.
Alive? How is she here?
We have borrowed her consciousness for a bit to testify on your worthiness for the good place. Would you mind telling us about the time you were dismissed and what happened thereafter?
I'm afraid that what I say might injure the madame.
Miss Odette Sullivan will not be able to harm you no matter what you say. It is in yours and her best interest to tell the truth and the whole truth only.
I always worked very hard in the office and made sure that I never made a mistake. One day, I received news that the condition of my mother at the hospital was getting worse. I know that my mother will push through, but I couldn't help feeling a tiny bit worried. I wasn't quite myself that day and made a terrible mistake that I didn't know would cost me my job.
We interrupt this program for a quick reminder.
Right now, you may have more questions than answers. Hand-in-Hand Comprehensive Therapy Specialists are still here for you and your family. Our counselors are providing telehealth appointments to keep your family safe. During the uncertainty of this time, routine appointments can help families stay on the path of progress. Anxiety and depression can arise or worsen while the stay-at-home order is in place. So let us help you cope, and we are happy to accept new referrals. Send us a message on the Contact Us page of handinhandtherapy.com.
You're still listening to For a Day More at 99.9 Evander Radio.
That day, I was tasked with deleting all the unneeded files and folders on Madame's computer. I didn't realize that I had deleted the files of her latest designs, which weren't even released yet. It was quite stupid of me. The madame found out and fired me instantly. I'm very sorry for deleting your files, ma'am.
You better be. I worked hard on those designs. My poor darling's flashed away because of some stupid ingrate.
On the contrary, it wasn't really her who deleted your designs. It was you, Miss Sullivan.
What?
You accidentally deleted your files when you were about to save them and unknowingly blamed it on your personal assistant.
But if I hadn't permanently deleted them, Madame Odette wouldn't have to create new designs.
Oh, don't be daft. Of course I didn't do redesigns. All of my work is automatically saved on the cloud and my flash drive.
Of course. Madame is always prepared. Then, if I may ask, why did you still fire me?
Do you really expect me to trust somebody as clumsy as you again after that farce?
I see. Madame is right. Madame is always right.
Miss Vermont, tell us what happened after your unfortunate dismissal.
Where was I? I tried to plead for Madame not to fire me, but you know how Madame is. Once she made up her mind, she can't be swayed. She deceives like that. Well, I couldn't do anything about it, so I just went to the hospital to visit my mother. I didn't have the heart to tell her that I was fired when her health was steadily declining. I talked to the nurses and they told me that there's some medicines that I had to buy for my mother. I didn't know where to get the money to buy the meds, so I prayed that she would stay strong while I tried to find another job. I couldn't find a job that pays as much as my previous position. I can only pay for my mother's stay at the hospital. One thing led to another, and my mom
ended up comatose because I couldn't pay for her maintenance. I mean, it could be a lot worse. I'm glad my mother is still alive. There's still hope. I keep trying my best to take care of her. I guess that's all, Your Honor?
Her mother has been sick since she was a toddler. I fail to see how any of that is my fault.
Odette is still stood by her claim that she deserved to go to the good place. She had no regrets. At least, that's what she told herself.
Thank you for your honesty, Miss Vermont. You may now return.
Thank you, Your Honor. Thank you too, Madam.
Whatever for?
For employing me in your company for 5 years, even though I just graduated. I appreciated that. This is the strangest dream.
Bring the second witness in.
What? What is this place?
Herman Sullivan, current CEO of Attire and Allure Fashion Brand, father of the defendant, testifying. Current status, alive.
Of course I'm alive, you blundering fool. War I am is abducted. How dare you strangers bring me to this place without my permission?
The witness has accidentally brought along his subordinate.
I'll send her back.
I'm not done talking to her!
Please, sir. I don't want to lose my job.
We have very little time left if we tarry any longer. According to your world's law, I will have to put your name down on obstruction of justice, Mr. Sullivan.
Fine! We are not done here, you hear me?
The subordinate nods her head rapidly and disappears in a twinkle of lights.
Let's wrap this up quickly. I have a meeting in 30, and a Sullivan is never late, so get on with it.
Tell us about the time when your daughter, Miss Odette Sullivan, still lived under your roof, and what made her decide to move out and start her own brand?
Odette? The girl is here?
He turns to Odette as he was only made aware of her presence at that moment.
Haha, I see. You finally got yourself caught in the change of the law, huh? How far the mighty have fallen?
Maybe I just went down here so I can talk to you at eye level. Father.
Please proceed with your testimony, Mr. Sullivan.
Okay, here we go. Every head of the company is an organized and respectable man. Odette was my only child, yet I never considered her the heir of my empire. Women cannot be trusted with such heavy responsibilities. They are destined to fail.
Wow, some people never change, huh?
I raised Odette to be a perfect daughter, with the manners of a queen and the bearing of a goddess. She would have never had to lift a finger in her life if only she stood still and stayed quiet.
I am your daughter, not a trophy to be displayed. You paraded me around like one of your mannequins in garish dresses waiting for the highest bidder. I can't shut up and sell my freedom away like that.
We interrupt this program for a quick reminder.
It is now 12:05 in the evening.
This time check is brought to you by the Department of Health. You're still listening to For a Day More at 99.9 Evander Radio.
I propose that we leave it at that and finish Mr. Herman's testimony in a calmer manner. All in favor?
At any rate, all that I have said is true. That girl betrayed my trust and muddied my clean white reputation. It was at the event of sponsors that she dared to betray me. A special event that is only held once every decade. Designs are presented to an audience to gain the attention of sponsors. The brand will get the most offers, receive support for the next decade till the next event is held. I never expected Odette, my own daughter, to create her own brand behind my back, much less steal the designs of my company.
And these designs were created by you?
Of course not! They were made by the company's designers. But nevertheless, they all belong to me. And she had the audacity to steal them. She stole the support of the company that we held for 50 years straight. If I could, I would claim to have never had a daughter. But I am merciful. I let her keep the family name on the condition that we never speak again.
I gave that condition to you. God.
You lasted longer than I thought in the business, even though you were a girl. But I guess I was right. Women will still fail and screw up the precious opportunities given to them.
The female workers I employed at my company were 20 times more productive than yours. They all had more potential in their fingertips than every fiber in your entire body combined.
Senseless! Squeaking of a rat caught in a trap. That's all I have to say, Your Honor. If you would please excuse me, I have a meeting to catch. I hope you get the ending that you deserve, my dearest daughter.
And I hope you do too.
Odette told Peter that such unpleasant aspects of her life were getting needlessly exposed just so she could prove that she deserves to be in a good place. There were much more good things about her, weren't there?
Well, how much longer will this charade go on? I hope you bring a better witness. The last two were subpar and couldn't even appreciate my excellence.
Not to worry. This case will soon be over. Bring in the final witness.
Ophelia Reyes, wife of Antonio, aka Tony Reyes, a tricycle driver, testifying. Current status, deceased.
I'll try my best, Your Honor.
Once Miss Sullivan has honored us with her silence, then we may proceed with the testimony.
Well, I never. I refuse to let the stranger testify and...
You may now proceed. Miss Reyes, would you tell us about the circumstances which ultimately led to your untimely death?
It was quite some time ago, so please give me a moment to remember. It was a night like any other night. My dear Tony noticed that I was out of medicine, so he went out to buy some more. I waited for him, and thought it was taking him a bit longer than usual to get them. I then assumed that it was due to the heavy traffic. But then, someone came and informed me that my husband had been apprehended. They didn't know where, and they didn't know when. Well, some said he banged his tricycle, or a car crashed into him. It wasn't really clear. All the conflicting information made me so anxious that I felt like the world was spinning out of control. Well, the only sure thing they could tell me was that he won't be able to make it home anytime soon. We were just the two of us living in the countryside. All our children were grown up and had their respective families in the city. That's why I didn't know how to contact them. I never really understood how those new phones worked anyway. So, I couldn't call for anybody and nobody came for me. For days, I was without my medication and felt myself getting weaker as the days dragged on. I couldn't travel on my own to buy my medicine since I was too weak. I couldn't even visit my husband, which I very much wanted to do. So, alone and pining for my beloved, I breathed my last. As I felt my last breath leaving me, I felt sad that I couldn't be with my Tony. But I was consoled by the thought that he would no longer have to scrounge for money for my medicines.
Yes, and the person who crashed into the tricycle of Antonio Reyes on the 25th of February, year 2000, was in fact Miss Odette Sullivan.
Unfortunately, no, Your Honor. But wait, are you saying someone crashed into him? And not the other way around?
Odette was surprised. She couldn't remember such a car crash happening before in her life. She had always been a careful driver. Wait.
the night before the sponsor's event. She was driving much faster than her usual speed and urgency.
I...
prepared to fight for her honor. She looks at the elderly lady and was surprised to find pity in her eyes. She's not angry. She feels sorry for me. Why?
The court thanks you for your honesty. You may now return in peace.
Odette thought to herself,
what in the world just happened?
That was the final witness, Your Honor. We now await the final verdict.
Both of the supernatural beings turn their heads towards the death.
What are you two staring at me for?
You previously stated that you deserve to be in the good place. Do you still stand by that claim?
Why do you ask? It's not like it matters anyway. You're the one who's deciding my fate.
I never declared that I would be the one to decide.
The judge's exact words were, I am only the judge, the guardian of the celestial crossroads. You are here to see if you are worthy of the good place or the bad place.
It is yours and yours only to decide whether you are worthy of the good place or the bad place. So, what do you have in mind, Miss Odette Sullivan?
Me?
Odette felt conflicted. At the start of the trial, she was convinced that she deserved to go to the good place, but now she felt that she was far from anyone who had the right for a spot in the good place, and there was more than enough evidence and broken hearts to prove that.
I've hurt more people than I thought in my life. Someone died because of me, and I didn't even receive the anger I expected from her. I've made my decision. I've made my decision. We all know where I belong. If I could have another day more to fix it all, I would take it. But I'm dead already, and I have to accept the consequences of my actions. I deserve to go to the bad place.
The judge gives her a resolute nod and bangs her gavel.
Turns out I didn't die after all, and all of that craziness was just a dream. Though it felt too vivid to be a dream. Maybe I really was standing in that court. Maybe I really met my ex-BA, my father, and Ophelia. Who knows? All I know is that I learned something. Something precious. This is my second chance at life, and I'm determined to make the best of it. One day at a time.
We've reached the end of another episode of Late Night Talks at 99.9 Avenger Radio. Thank you for tuning in. This is DJ Sebastian from LHS.
And this is DJ Torres from LHS. The voice of 99.9 Avenger Radio. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, Philippines, and everywhere beyond. Have a nice day. Goodbye.